this out. This something deep. Make Jesus say, shall I say, the word of God say, that he ain't coming back until you say, blessed is he who come in the name of the Lord. What? He making it hard for us. I'm not gonna say them. I'm gonna say us. He ain't coming back till you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. So that means if a man come to you in the name of the Lord and he drunk and he coming to you with this word right here, the word of God, or he smoking a cigarette, or he got a bad habit, he a drug addict trying to find his way back, and the word of God then came back to him. But everybody ain't gonna listen to him. Not too many religious people. No. But he coming and he quoting scripture. But the Lord trying to bring him back. He going to God. But this habit got him. But you know what? He can say when somebody else come to him and minister to him. He can say, man, God, God bless you, man, for giving me that word. And Jesus gonna come to him, the word of God coming to him, because he said, blessed is he who done came in the name of the Lord. Jesus said, who will love me the most? And the disciples said, those who are forgiven most. He said, you have answered that correct. It was a while before he sent his word down and made flesh to dwell among us. And even after that, he still ain't learned a lesson. We still ain't learned. Man, God meant don't eat of that tree of good and evil. He meant that. And he said don't even look at it. Revelation comes when you find out what war went on in heaven. When you find out what Michael Archangel stood for. What in his anger. When you find out what Satan and his angels stood for. And when you find out who talked to Adam and Eve and eating that fruit. Man, when you get to tapping in this right here, you get tearing on it. Because there's somebody watching. It's somebody watching all around. Even when you're by yourself. It's somebody that know that God got his hands on you. And what? You can be over there by yourself. He gonna send somebody to stop you from talking to another brother. From speaking the word of God. He gonna send one of his angels to stop you from speaking the word of God to another brother. One of these times when you sit down to eat and everybody know you belong to Christ, when you get ready to sit down to eat, don't bless your food and watch. And watch what's going to happen when you're in a room full of people. Somebody watch. And somebody that done ate off that tree of good and evil, guess what they gonna do? They gonna judge you, and they gonna say, man, you plan to be a Christian, and you didn't even bless your food. You know what you need to say then? I thank God for everything that he give me. I thank him when he ain't giving to me. Man, when he taking, I'm thanking. I'm thanking God when I'm suffering, and I'm thanking God when I'm on top. Because a lot of times I'm on top, but I want to be on the bottom. Because I know to become first, but first become last. Man, I thank God when I go to the store and buy the food. I thank him when I get my check. What? The same food you see in me right now that I didn't bless so you can see it. Man, it's been blessed. Oh, it's been blessed. Man, I put that order in a long time ago. You know how many years it's been since I blessed this food? This food was blessed when I was born again. When I gave my life to God. Because I found out who was asking for a drink of water. I found out who it was that was coming to me to ask me for a drink of water. When a man come to me down, when a man come to me needing some water, needing some meat, home, saying, man, pray for me. What? I found out a long time ago who he was. That was Jesus. And they say what color he is. What? Ain't no flesh gonna see that. Ain't gonna be no color. Like I said, Romans 1 and 25 says, who changed the truth of God into a lie and worship and serve preacher, more than the creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. There was a rich man, and there was a bum named Lazarus, who ate crumbs from the rich man's table. And it came to pass that the bum, the word of God called him a beggar. But today, we know him as a bum, homeless. The Bible also said in Luke 15:21 that he desired to be where and who he was. And it came to pass that the beggar died. And the rich man, he died also. Then the rich man lifted up his eyes in torment, and he saw Abraham afar off with Lazarus in his bosom, and he cried, saying, "Father Abraham, please have mercy on me, and send Lazarus that he may dip his finger in water and cool my tongue, because I'm burning in these flames." But Abraham said, "Son, remember, in your lifetime, you received good things." And he said, "Son, all your treasures stored up on earth. But Lazarus, he received evil things. All his life, he was homeless. But now, he is comforted, because he believed that his treasure would be laid up in heaven." Abraham told the rich man, "I can't help you." The rich man said, "Can you just send Lazarus back to warn my brother, or else they'll come here too?" And Abraham said to him, "They have Moses and the prophet. Let them hear them." But he said, "They ain't gonna listen, cause I didn't listen." He said, "But if you send someone that come back from the dead, they'll repent then." And Abraham said, "If they didn't hear Moses and the prophet, then they not listening to them now, they not worthy to be here." Everybody around you, you start learning how to discern who is who. Jesus said, "Who will love me the most? Those who are forgiven most." And I had to be forgiven for a lot. When I found out who he was, I said, "Lord, I don't want you to have to come to me for the water. I want to offer up water to the world from you."
Yeah, yeah. Oh, are you thirsty? Come and drink. Yeah. Are you thirsty? Come and drink. Yeah. Are you thirsty? Come and drink. Yeah. Oh, oh. Don't need no money to receive it. Oh, I'm hungry. Come and eat. Yeah. Yeah. It's free.
He told the woman at the well, "If you knew who was asking you for a drink of water, you would ask him for water, and he would give you water." that you will never, ever thirst again. And guess how many husbands that woman had? That woman had 5 different husbands. And the one that she was with was not her husband. And she got saved that day. You know why I know she got saved that day? Because she went to bragging on Jesus Christ. That woman went to bragging on the word of God. What? Man, can't nobody come up to me and ask me for no water and I ain't giving them none. Can't nobody come to me and ask me for no food and I ain't giving them none. And I ain't talking about water for the drink or food for the stomach. I'm talking about the water and food Jesus was talking about when they came back the second day. And they was looking for food. And Jesus said, the food I got ain't for your stomach. He said, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word, bread, spoken out of the mouth of God. You gotta eat this right here. When you eat the word of God, he the true vine, we the branch. When you grow, you're going to become a branch, and you're going to produce fruit. And the fruit is the word of God. And don't stop there, because you're going to have to take that fruit, and you're going to have to stomp on it some and make new wine. What? Challenge gonna start there. But you gotta take this wine and put it in new skin, because you can't put new wine in old skin. So when you walk up to Jesus, when you walk up to the word of God, when you walk up to that man, because Jesus said, when I came to your thirst, you didn't give me nothing to drink. When I came to your home, you didn't give me nothing to eat. When I came to you in prison, he said, when I was in prison, you didn't even come there. So when a man come to you home, you know what he got. He got a new heart. He ready for you to pour that new wine. But when the world get this right here, it's gonna be people walking around. They know all they gotta do is walk through the hospital. We can go to the hospital right now, laughing and joking, like a normal day. You can walk through the hospital. And people just gonna start getting up, feeling good. Can be healed. Because when you walk through there, you know who name you going in there in. You going in there in the name of the very word of God. You ain't got to put your hands on. If you know who you coming in there in the name of, you know God done sent you. All you got to do, just breathe. Breathe the word of God out in the air. And people just gonna start getting healed. It's all about the faith. Why, oh why, do you spend money on food and brew? And you labor for the thing that cannot satisfy. Listen to me, says God, and eat that which is good. Oh, hear the word of the Lord. I am the door. And if anyone enters in by me, he shall be saved. And he shall go in and out and find good pasture. But the thief, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Jesus Christ, the Word of God, I come that you may.